In this video, we'll go through the computation questions from one CXC CSEC multiple choice mathematics examination. Remember, calculators are not allowed in this exam. To get the most out of this video, pause it here and resume when you have an answer for each question. If you get stuck on any, check the description below for the link to the video that covered that topic. Okay, let's go. 2/3 squared is equal to 2/3 multiplied by 2/3. 2 multiplied by 2 is equal to 4. 3 multiplied by 3 is equal to 9. The answer is D. What percentage of 340 is 425? Rephrased, 425 is what percentage of 340? Thus, as a fraction, we are talking about 425 divided by 340. To convert a percentage, we multiply by 100%. Working out 425 divided by 340 multiplied by 100. The easiest way I find to do this is to cancel as much as possible. I can tell that 5 could go into both 425 and 340. 5 into 4, 25. 5 into 4 cannot. 5 into 42, 8. We have 2 remaining. 5 into 25 is 5. We have 85. 5 into 340, 68. So we have 85 over 68 multiplied by 100. What number could go into both 68 and 85? No number is immediately obvious that could go into both, so we try 68 and 100. You can immediately recognize that 2 could go into both 68 and 100. 2 into 100 is 50. 2 into 68, 34. 2 could go into both again. 2 into 50, 25. 2 into 34, 17. No number could go into both 17 and 25. What about 17 and 85? It may not be immediately obvious, but 17 multiplied by 5 is 85. 5 over 1 multiplied by 25%. 5 over 1 is the same as 5 multiplied by 25%. It's equal to 125%. The answer is C. The ratio of Ann to Betty is 2 to 3. 2 shares is equal to $120. Using the unitary method, we find for 1 share. 1 share is equal to $120 divided by 2. We ask to find Betty's share. Betty's share is equal to 3 shares is equal to, we know what 1 share is, so we multiply by 3 to get 3 shares. 120 divided by 2 multiplied by 3, which is equal to $180. The answer is C. We are given that 12.5% is equal to $40. We are asked to find the total sum of money. We are asked to find 100%. Using the unitary method, we find for 1%. 1% is equal to $40 divided by 12.5. Thus, 100% is equal to $40 divided by 12.5 multiplied by 100. This calculation may give some people problems, so I will attempt it from a few different ways. I know that 1/8 is equal to 12.5 or 12.5% or 0.125. So I have recognized that 12.5 into 100 is equal to 8. 12.5 into 12.5 is 1. 12.5 into 100 is 8. To get $40 by 8 is $320 to get B. But if you did not recognize that, don't fear, we'll figure it out another way. We could work out 40 divided by 12.5 first and then multiply by 100. 40 divided by 12.5 is equal to 40 divided by 12 multiplied by 2 is 24 plus 1, 25 over 2, which is the same as 40 multiplied by 2 over 25. 5 into 25, 5. 5 into 40, 8. 8 twos are 16, 16 over 5. 16 over 5 is equal to 3 and 1/5. We know that 1/5 is 0.2, 3.2. So we found out that $40 divided by 12.5 is equal to $3.20. $3.20 multiplied by 100 is equal to $320. So that's B. 29.94 multiplied by 0.5 is approximately 30 multiplied by 0.5. Which is approximately 30 multiplied by 0.5 or 30 multiplied by half is equal to 15. So the answer is thus C. The ratio of pupils to teachers is 20 to 1. There are 840 pupils, which means that 20 shares is equal to 840. We want to find out how many teachers there are. We want to find out what is one share. One share, which is the number of teachers, is equal to 840 divided by 20. 10 into 840 is 84. 10 into 20 is 2. 84 divided by 2 is equal to 42. 42 teachers. The answer is B. I am Mr. Dube.
Remember, to get the most out of my channel, please view the videos in order using the playlist.
If you found this video useful, please like this video. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. Join me in the next video.